I...
This is Fallout 76 in a microcosm. For a litany of reasons, this should not exist. Fallout 76 is a lot of Bethesda saying, hey, we know what most of you guys want, so here's something else that will hopefully make us more money instead. And you know what? It might. This isn't the first time Bethesda has taken massive liberties with the Fallout name. We can't forget that at one time, Fallout was a top-down isometric RPG that helped define freedom of play, long before Bethesda had the license to the franchise. This, however, is different. Fallout 76 doesn't just change what it means to be a Fallout game, regardless of its purported status as, I guess, a spin-off. It changes what it means to be a AAA multiplayer game in 2018 and 2019. And in far too many ways, those are steps taken in massively polarizing directions, and too many are not even close to being for the better. That doesn't mean there isn't some good to be found in 76, and I'll talk about it, but it's important to look at this outside of the spectrum of a review and really examine the reality of one simple question. Why exactly does Fallout 76 exist, and should it? And then, after that's all said and done, I'm going to offer up what a solution could have or should be when it comes to solving most of 76's issues. Fallout 76 is an exercise in paradoxes. How is it possible for a game to be this great, and at the same time, so ridiculously terrible in so many ways? So today we're going to examine that. What makes Fallout 76 in so many ways so wrong, and then at the same time, what in some ways makes it kind of great? Today we're going to look at all of those things, and most importantly, we're going to look at what Fallout 76 should have been, examining what could have fixed this game. So to get started, let's take a look at maybe one of its biggest problems. Let's get something out of the way from the jump. A decent game, maybe even a good game, is fun with friends. A great game is great without conditions. If you have to play a game a certain way to extract enjoyment, there's an inherent flaw with that product, without question. Fallout 76 is a shell of a Fallout game, and I mean that literally. It's as though they took Fallout 5 halfway through world design and said, that's enough, just go ahead and get it out. This is one of the few nearly objective negatives when it comes to 76. It's so damn empty feeling. There are cool environmental stories to be told, things like Mothman and Holotape Tales, but Fallout 76's desolation hits you like a wave of dust after the bomb drops and it never settles. Too many houses are boarded up, too many locales are simply empty places filled with literal junk and a few enemies. Almost all of the character of past Fallout games has completely evaporated. What used to be a hobby of picking a point and walking in past Fallout games in that direction has now turned into an exercise of cardboard box points of interest and vast nothingness. Which is a bit strange given that the world itself was the very basket Bethesda placed all their eggs in past games. These problems are greatly exacerbated by the fact that Bethesda decided to completely remove NPCs, which, until you actually sit down and play it, you can't understand the depths of how this affects the gameplay experience. You trade with vending machines and bots, your only human voices coming from holotapes and the radio, and in turn, what relatively little narrative there is feels hollow and detached. It's hard to care about something when the only exposure you get to it is some sporadic vocal recordings and a few journal entries. And that's a shame because the Scorched and their story is actually pretty damn interesting, but without actual character and effort, it feels forced. It's sometimes even sad. You can actually do things like play through a faction quest line like you might have with the Brotherhood of Steel in past games, but once again, it's just a series of empty quests trotting through an empty world, playing a game of, look, something used to be here, now it's not. Sure, it is fun to explore the wasteland with friends, but it's that make your own fun kind of fun, and as great as that can be, it doesn't reflect well on the game that playing it alone is at times a pain, and playing it with friends is fun with conditions, and that's thanks to a world underdeveloped and a narrative missing its heart. I've spoken about it before, but even the intro, leaving the vault, no well-developed exiting the vault moment, just a time to go get out. It's just not Fallout. But damn if Bethesda doesn't try to make these problems even bigger once you start pressing buttons. Throughout the beta, I actually didn't suffer through that many issues with 76. I was mostly bugged and problem-free. I had my share of disconnects and small glitches, but many suffered far worse than I did. I thought I was lucky. Now, with far more time in the game, it appears to have caught up with me. Fallout 76 is a mess. Now, admittedly, this will vary from person to person. You may never see a single bug, but more so than ever, that is highly unlikely. Fallout 76 doesn't just suffer from traditional Bethesda bugs. It's hit in ways that break a multiplayer game. On PS4, at least, you will disconnect and disconnect and disconnect in Fallout 76. In the middle of a PvP battle, while trading, it doesn't matter. This is exacerbated by the fact that should you be logged out for any reason during a live event or daily quest, you will lose your progress, which means you can be on your way to returning your quest items for your rewards and be disconnected only to lose all your progress in that quest and all your time, and it happens way too often. Hell, you can pay to fast travel to a live event, disconnect, live event is gone, and you lost caps for nothing. Even moving past the disconnects, the creation engine and AI that Bethesda will not abandon are far too archaic to be in any game in 2019. These kinds of glitches happen far too often. Enemies will leave out of existence, quest bots won't move, making the quest uncompletable and wasting chunks of your time, not to mention that the game still looks like a last-gen game outside of the genuinely great lighting and dynamic weather effects. That it's a feature joke is no longer funny. Fallout 76 costs $60, includes microtransactions, and isn't finished. It needed more time, it needed a new engine. AI like the Scorched are not a challenge, mostly because they're incapable of being so. They're not even remotely a threat, they're relatively dumb. Too many enemies can be outsmarted by a 2-foot-tall road rail, and the enemies that are great, like the Grafted Monster or Deathclaws, are able to be manipulated too easily as well. And yes, it might be cool to explore a post-nuclear Fallout 76, but that's a treat you wait for and doesn't alleviate any of the issues, even if it changes the enemies and the landscape. But let's look past that. What do you get when it works? Well, remember when you were younger and your parents would tell you to pick up your room, so like a hoarder, you ran around, picked stuff up, and like a hoarder again, threw them all in your closet. That's what it's like playing Fallout 76 for far too much of your playtime. A lot of past Fallout games have been defined by fetch quest after fetch quest, but they were broken up by character development, conversation, romance, trading, amazing locales and cities. Fallout 76's gameplay loop is all too often a repetitive grind. I get it, these MMO lights need active quests and live events, but they can and should be more. Almost all of Fallout's quests are as simple as they can be. Go here, collect this, stand here, kill this. It's so empty that many quests actually act as just simple horde modes where you simply stand in one area and take out as many unintelligent enemies as you can and hope to get something interesting in return. You normally don't, or at least I didn't, given that you probably won't spend much time in PvP using that gear there, it's a risk-reward, especially when the gunplay is still average and all sorts of other problems exist, and as already mentioned, the live event and daily quest issues already have their own problems. Now with friends, this isn't so bad, for short bursts of fun, but most live events and daily quests, one of your main sources, again, of high-level gear, follow these same gameplay loops, and after a while, even with others, you're left wondering what the point is. And sure, you could say that about a lot of MMO lights, but you can't normally say that about a Fallout game. The building, which very few people enjoyed in the first place, has also been doubled down on to break all of that up, where the narrative doesn't. But even that is just a manipulative system. There's junk everywhere, but it only appears to be there to fill the usually empty space and make you feel like you accomplished something by finding it. But collecting and scrapping gets old fast, so does building, especially when you can't pause the game to access your Pip-Boy, so becoming over-encumbered can be deadly even trying to build in a forest. It's also a bit of a confusing message from Bethesda about the building anywhere. You can't actually build anywhere. You can't really set up camp anywhere that interesting at all. You won't be building forts on top of buildings, you'll be setting up shop in a wide open forest space and playing in that area where it allows you to. Fallout 76 is fetch, horde, build, and for some people this will be a primarily social game and that's all they're looking for, which is great, but for a lot of people this will get old incredibly fast. And none of this has anything to do with the game's bigger issues that have already been discussed, but now we can at least get to the good. Fallout 76 is maybe unfortunately great in a few ways, enough to make it feel like a missed opportunity. The enemy variety here, once you get past the lower level play, is amazing. New enemies mixed with old, and some unique enemies are nothing short of awesome. I already mentioned the Grafton Monster, a headless, waste-like horror, an individualized enemy that makes stumbling upon him during exploration after just having heard about him throughout the world a bright spot. The lighting is, as previously mentioned, incredible and perfectly suited for the most colorful Fallout game to date, and most weather-diverse Fallout game to date. Which is why it sucks that so much of the world feels uninteresting. And better yet, that poorly executed narrative is intriguing. The Scorched are cool looking, and the realities of this new spread of terrors are actually intriguing and worth digging into regardless of how you have to do it. And to Bethesda's credit, as annoying as things like the food and water system can be, it's less abrasive and intrusive as it could have been, and rarely becomes annoying. It also doesn't make the experience more survival-like, and so it does seem a bit like a pointless system even in late-game scenarios, but it's not bad. And I do actually enjoy the new perk system, and the excitement of opening card packs as you level up adds to that enjoyment. All of these things are good within the Fallout formula. I guess the problem is, they didn't add these things to Fallout 5. They didn't adjust these things in Fallout 5, they did it in a game that barely shares that Fallout identity. So how can this be fixed? How should it have been? Problems without solutions are nothing but empty words. I've said it before, and I'm sure I'll say it again. Sometimes the solutions are so obvious they don't even need to be verbalized. Other times, they're so obvious that they should be verbalized because somehow they were overlooked. Fallout 76 is not a terrible idea. It's just been so poorly executed that it's hard to get fully behind it, and that's because of seemingly intentional design decisions that detract from what should have been a significantly better experience. Fallout 76 should have been Fallout 5, plain and simple. Built on a new engine or an overhaul creation engine, and cooperative play should have been a choice. It's not that difficult to build multiplayer into a Fallout world, we've seen mods do it. Hell, 76 attempts it, so instead of shitting out a multiplayer Fallout with absolutely none of the soul of the franchise, build Fallout 5. Build it with NPCs with a proper narrative structure with a Fallout-caliber world that works in isolation. From there, take 76's living multiplayer structure and integrate it. Don't want to play with others? Turn off multiplayer or go offline. Want to engage in PvP? Start up your game in a PvP server or simply turn off pacifist mode. Want to bring your low-level friend on a high-level quest with you? Do so at his own risk and lend him some gear, getting rid of the pointless gear level system. This can't happen in Fallout 76 because most of these systems don't operate as they really should in this game already, so you can't supplant them and put them in a normally narrative-driven structure. And for those that say, well, what about branching paths? You're right. A simple and true narrative with branching paths, NPCs, and so on could have solved so many of 76's problems. Sure, it would require you to get rid of the seamless multiplayer and convert to a more traditional invite from peer-to-peer multiplayer system, but the game would be far less disappointing and satisfy the same crowd looking for multiplayer in the process because that's what people were asking for in the crowds that were asking for it. I don't think that anyone, well at least anecdotally anyone I know, was hoping for 76's brand of multiplayer Fallout. Not at all. I think there were and still are some people that simply want to invite their friends into their Fallout game and run through the Brotherhood questline together or explore a high-level area. That would be an incredible experience. Instead, we get a multiplayer game that does everything except make you feel like you're playing a Fallout game with friends. You're just playing a Fallout-themed game. Fallout 76 will grow, there's no question about that. It will likely receive a cacophonous amount of new content, it will receive big expansions and small ones alike, and it'll change. What it turns into is anyone's guess, but the character flaws beneath the surface of the game are simply too hard to ignore and maybe too much to correct post-release. I hope I'm wrong, but there's not much you can do when the very premise of your game flies so directly in the face of the very realities you built your franchise around. 76 is not necessarily offensive, it isn't some greedy cash grab, it just isn't very good as it exists today at the time of this writing. But Fallout 76 needs to act as a lesson to Bethesda. Ideas mean nothing if you can't execute them. Just because something sounds like a good idea doesn't mean it is if you can't bring it to life. Bethesda needs to take the time, take the money they most certainly have and rebuild for the future. They need to either entirely overhaul the creation engine or build a new one because it's no longer serving its purpose. They need to read the room. They need to understand their audience because if they can't hear the noise, pretty soon, there'll be no one left there to make it.
Well, guys, that is it for today's video, and as always, start of a dialogue. Now it's your turn. What do you think of Fallout 76? Do you have any interest in it at all? Are you going to play it? Why or why not? And maybe more importantly, what do you think Fallout 76 should change? What do you think should come to the game in the future or shift about the game in the future that could make you pick it up? Or, better yet, make you enjoy what you've already purchased? Let me know the answers to any of those questions down in the comments below. Let's have a real conversation. And as always, if you enjoyed this video, hit that like button. If you're not yet a member of this team, press subscribe. I put out gaming analysis and examinations just like this one twice a week. They'll come when they come. No promise on days, but it's usually twice a week. So hit subscribe so you do not miss any of those. My Twitter handle will be in the top pinned comment down below. It's there you can find out what games I'm playing, participate in polls so I know what games you guys want to see come to the channel next, and just talk about things that aren't games sometimes. Really quickly, some quick updates. Obviously, new backdrop. That's going to change in a week again, so I don't even know why I felt the need to mention it. But even more importantly, I do want to start, and I'm going to use the YouTube community tab as well, but are you guys interested at all in the premiere function? I've done it once before. I don't think it was on this channel, but I've used the feature. Do you guys enjoy that? Do you want to be able to watch it live with me when it comes out, be able to chat with me? Are you interested in that at all? Let me know the answer to that question as well in the comments. And other than that, guys, that is it. I'll see you in the next video. Until then, I'm out.